See if I can pick a less popular song. Okay, maybe this will get by since it's from a more not as well-known movie. All right, so lay back for your sit-ups. Like, where am I at? Okay, we're gonna do up and singles with hold. Up, hold, down. Last step, slow down. One, two, three, four. We're gonna be back at singles with a hold. If I can make you stop and take a look at me instead of just up. There's nothing that I wouldn't do if it was getting you to notice. Pause. We're gonna do super slows. 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Halves. Half. Up. Half. Down. Half. Up. Half. Down. Half. Up. Half. Down. So you know it's me. All right, yay. And they didn't flag the video. Flip on over. You're gonna go ahead and push on up. Stretch out your abdominal muscles. Okay, next one, we're gonna grab our weights. We're gonna work on our triceps. Once again, have to find a... So maybe that won't get flagged. Interesting. Well, if anything, I'll make the videos again later. Or I'll just put a thing up so that the people on YouTube know why they don't have a video. So, it is what it is. Alright, so for triceps, you can start with two weights, and then if it gets too heavy, go down to one. And use both hands for it. If it gets too heavy, put both down. And just do it with just your arms moving slowly. Okay, so we're doing tricep extensions, which is your hands behind your head, extended up, forward. So it's like you're getting ready to throw like an axe over your head. We'll see what we can get with. Maybe because it's an older song, we'll be okay. Singles.
Thank you.
talk over it once we flight.
Halves. 1, 2, 3, 4. Singles. Singles, fast up, slow down. 2, 3, 4. Fast up, slow down. Halves. Singles, down, up. Slow, 1, 2, 3, 4. Singles. Halves. Nice job with that. So that's tricep extensions. So your triceps, in case you don't know, are right here on the back of your arm. To stretch that out, you want to make the muscle, once again, as long as possible. Pull behind your head and pull back. Okay, so that will help out a lot on that side, as well as it can help out if you pull across the top. It goes a little bit higher in case you feel it more closer to the shoulder side versus underneath towards the armpits. Okay, next one we're going to do is squats. So you're just going to do it standing. Quick thing for squats, make sure that you're shoulder width apart, if not a little bit wider. I know I've gone over that with a lot of people in the classes, but just in case you have family members and stuff doing it too. A quick thing you want to check when you do your squat is you want to make sure that your feet, as you squat, stay flat against the mat. You don't want to be coming up, you don't want to have your toes coming up. And then same thing, you want your knees to go straight forward above your feet, not buckling together, not going out to the sides. Okay, if you want to use weights, you can. 5 pounds, 10 pounds won't do a lot for the lower body. You're lifting a heavier weight than that just by lifting your own body up, okay? This one, probably because of time, because I try to keep it within about 30 minutes, will probably be our last one, and then we'll do a little bit of a stretch out. What song am I not going to get in trouble for? Oh, well, might as well go big or go home. We go together. Got emails coming. Okay, we're going to start with singles. Should I do a side of it? See if we can. Halves. Half. Down. Half. Up. Half. Down. Half. Up. Okay, and slow. 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. Slow again. Slow. Back to singles. 1, 2. You notice everything's kind of based on a 4 count, which is also part of an 8 count. Slow. 1, 2, 3, 4. Keep slow. Okay, hold. Halfway hold. Relax. Halves. So we're doing it without actually like talking with people. Regular singles. Fast down, slow up. 1, 2, 3, 4. Holds. 1. Hold. We're doing super slow holds. 2. 3. 4. Going back the other way. 1. 2. 3. Make sure you're still engaged and all the way up. Up. Ready? In halves. Another slow. All right. That one, quadriceps right here in the front of your legs primarily. You have a little bit of hamstrings and gluteus maximus as well. If you feel it more in the quads, quad stretch, flamingo stretch, whatever you want to call it, make sure you're grabbing at the ankle, not at the foot, otherwise you're just stretching out your ankle joint. You want to be stretching your knee joint, okay? If you feel it more in your glutes and your booty, you can lay down or do standing. You want to do knee hugs, okay? Bringing up the knee to stretch out the back of the leg, okay? So tomorrow we're going to be doing, so this is called intervals just because of the time change. Tomorrow we're going to do actual interval training. So we're going to do high intensity, 30 seconds. It will be more cardio. 30 seconds on, 10 seconds off. Bring your own music for that one. So you can do headphones, blast in your house, whatever. That way you can do whatever's going to keep you pumped up during it, and I don't have to worry about things getting flagged with the music. So that will be tomorrow. You do not need any weights at all. If you have a jump rope, you can bring a jump rope for anything jumping, or you can just go and jump in place. Lastly, because it is cardio with lots of moving and bouncing, you don't want to be barefoot. So if you have a good pair of house shoes, something that has an arch support in it, because the jumping, that's how you hear about people with flat feet, or plantar fasciitis, or shin splints, things like that, is because they don't have good foot support. So you want to make sure you have something that keeps your foot up so that you can do good cardio with that. Nine again tomorrow. Otherwise, guys, good seeing you. And I'll post this for the people who couldn't make live. I usually do 9 a.m. just for the reason is you want to still get up like you usually did. So try not to be sleeping in all the time. That kind of messes with your body. All right, bye. See you guys later.